Hey friends, I'm Amy, a health coach here at Flip Your Leaf, and today we're going to talk about polyols, which is the P in FODMAP. Now, polyols are a little bit of a wild card on the low FODMAP diet, and that's because when we're talking about other FODMAPs, we're talking about short-chain carbohydrates, but when we're talking about polyols, we're talking about sugar alcohols. So these are chains that are like hundreds of molecules long, they're gigantic, that are traveling through your digestive system. And there are two kinds of polyols that are sort of managed during the low FODMAP diet, and that is sorbitol and mannitol. And these are naturally occurring polyols that you're going to find in like fruits and vegetables. You can also find them in manufactured foods. So we find them in like a lot of sugar-free products. So like gums, baked goods, soda pop. When you're looking for polyols, make sure you're looking for ol. So O-L at the end of all these. So it's going to be like a chemical sounding word and it's going to end in ol. So like xylitol. We got sorbitol, mannitol, maltitol. Like there's a bunch of them, but generally they end in O-L and that is a dead giveaway that there is a polyol in there somewhere. So the issue with polyols is they are osmotic molecules. And we've talked about this a bit before, but osmotic molecules are molecules that attract or pull water into the digestive tract. And so polyols are absorbed in the small intestine using passive diffusion, which is sort of if you had like a sieve and it was full of flour and we were giving it a shake, like it would take a bit for everything to come through, right? Because everything has to kind of settle into the right spot. The same kind of idea is happening with these polyols where they're kind of like bopping along your intestines. And when they find a place that they can, you know, sort of drop out of the intestine, they're going to do that. But this is a very slow process. And so while they're all sort of, you know, shaken out in our intestines, they're pulling in all of this water. And so, you know, we might be having abdominal distension or bloating, which is where you get that expanding belly, you get that feeling of pressure, you might have abdominal cramping and pain, you know, it can end up in diarrhea if there's enough water in there. Like they can be highly problematic if they're not being absorbed quickly enough. But something that's really interesting is that polyols are universally malabsorbed. So no one is absorbing all of the polyols that they eat. The issue here with people with IBS and the FODMAP diet is where is your threshold between like my body can deal with this amount of polyols, but it cannot deal with it anymore, right? It's finding that, you know, how big is my FODMAP bucket when it comes to these polyols? So another really interesting part is that piece is that even if you absorb the molecules eventually, they might have done enough damage while they were sitting there. And I don't mean physical damage, of course. I mean, like in the time that it took them to be absorbed, they may have pulled in enough water into your digestive tract that you're still ending up with all these issues. So you are full of water, you're feeling all that distension and bloating and abdominal pain, and the polyols that cause that have hightailed it out of your intestines. So like these guys are little buggers. Now, just to recap our idea for today, polyols are the P in FODMAP. And unlike other FODMAPs, which are short chain carbohydrates, polyols are sugar alcohols. And the issue here is that they are osmotic molecules, which means that they are actively attracting or pulling water into the bowel. And that can lead to issues like distension and bloating or cramping or abdominal pain or even diarrhea. And so it's really important that we understand where our threshold is, you know, how much space we have in this FODMAP bucket to keep our bodies feeling nice and healthy and happy while still bringing a variety of foods into our diet. Now, if you want to learn more about IBS and FODMAPs and really how to make your body feel like home, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video.